If you've toyed around with level editors for Doom, you may have noticed something peculiar whenever you place more than one player's start object. Placing more than one player's start will create Doomguy clones that don't appear to do anything. Without a doubt, you've tried to shoot these immobile comrades only to find out it also harms the player. Hell, it's even deadly. Hence why these clones are also called Voodoo dolls. So why does this hurt the player? Why the hell is this a feature? Let's find out, shall we? How about we start with the technical details first. Why does a second, immobile player appear when you place a second player one start? When a map loads, it iterates through a list of things that are built into the map. Each thing found will then be placed into the map using the pSpawnMapThing function. Inside the pSpawnMapThing function, there's a special condition if the thing ID is less than or equal to 4. Thing IDs 1, 2, 3, and 4 correspond with player starts 1, 2, 3, and 4 respectively. Why only 4? Because vanilla Doom supported 4 player multiplayer only. An interesting function call is made here. If the game is single player, spawn a player. Let's see what spawning a player does. It checks here if player 1 is playing, which is the case. Tries to set the uniform color here, and hey, this looks interesting. Here it assigns the MobJ's player to player 1. Now, you need to separate the MobJ from the player here. See the MobJ as the body, and the player as the soul. There can be many player 1 bodies, but only one player 1 soul. So what happens when you damage a Voodoo doll? For that we must check out the pDamageMobJ function. Here's something interesting. This essentially means that the Voodoo doll tracks two different health values, one for its own body and one for the soul. This can lead to some interesting phenomena. But first, let's move on with pDamageMobJ. When MobJ, or the body, reaches less than one health, it will call the pKillMobJ function. The Voodoo doll body will die. Again, the Voodoo doll retrieves the player's soul here, and affects the player in many ways. It makes the player non-solid, makes the player drop his weapon, and more. So, about those interesting phenomena. What if the player has 200 health and kills a Voodoo doll that only has 100 health? Well, the Voodoo doll dies, but the player doesn't. Sort of? The player drops his weapon and has its height set to 0. So what the hell happened here? Well, killing the MobJ bypassed some status bar specific code. Here the status bar checks if the player has died, but since the player's health is still positive, Doomguy's face still appears alive. It is worth noting that even when dead, monsters will still target you because the player health is still positive. They will keep attacking until you die a second time. What about the other way around? What if the player has lower health than the Voodoo doll? Well, simply put, John is a zombie! Doomguy's soul will die, but the body is still alive and kicking. pKillMobJ is never called, so the stuff that turns Doomguy into a corpse is skipped, but the status bar and weapon are clearly affected. Here's what happens. This code here checks if your weapon is ready, but there's also a check if the player's health is 0 or lower. If it is, it will lower the weapon into an unusable state. Monsters ignore you because they see that the player's health is 0 or lower. You can still interact with items, so when you grab some health, enemies will realize you're alive again and they will do their best to kill you. That's all cool and stuff, but is there anything useful you can do with Voodoo dolls? Well, definitely. Id Software themselves never used Voodoo dolls, but the folks who developed Final Doom found some creative Voodoo doll usage. The most infamous one is probably the one used in TNT Evolution's final level. This notorious platforming puzzle that instantly kills you if you get the sequence wrong uses a Voodoo doll. Each wrong side of the platform has a teleporting line dev that teleports you into a tiny room that contains a Voodoo doll. What happens here is that you essentially telefrag yourself and die. Plutonia also uses Voodoo dolls, but in a more generous fashion. In map 6, walking under this cube gives you items. How does that work? Simple. An out-of-bounds elevator is lowered when you walk underneath the cube. This elevator holds a Voodoo doll, which then interacts with items at the bottom of the elevator ride. Since the Voodoo doll shares the player's soul, it also shares its inventory. Other wads, like Scythe, use Voodoo dolls to kill the player based on a timer. Crossing a line death here will start a rising floor in a very tall room. After a while, the Voodoo doll gets crushed to death, therefore also killing the player. But wait, it gets more creative. If you use boom extensions, you can create stuff like conveyor belts. This opens up a ton of possibilities. You can create timed events using these conveyor belts. For example, you want a door to open after 10 seconds after pressing this switch. Out of bounds, the Voodoo doll is released onto a conveyor belt, which after a certain distance crosses a line depth that will open the main door. You can also create doors that require multiple switches to open. Using the same principles, the Voodoo doll will cross the line depth once all three doors have opened up. If you're a real turbo nerd, you can even make a calculator using Voodoo dolls and conveyor belts, since you can pretty much simulate binary logic. Xtroose made an 8-bit binary calculator that can add 2 decimal numbers and display the result in binary. What if you want to create a vanilla Doom map without all the fancy boom conveyor belts? No worries, because thanks to a trick that's barely a year old, you can do so. Behold, Myco portals. Or Miko portals, I don't know. Doomworld user Mycola found out that a sector that is at its minimum floor height, so floor height at minus 32,768, can do pretty weird stuff. Due to an underflow calculating Doomguy's new position, and the engine thinking that Doomguy is stuck in a ceiling, the game will teleport Doomguy to a valid position just underneath the ceiling. What does this have to do with conveyor belts? Well, whatever falls into the portal preserves its momentum. If you push a Voodoo doll into the portal using an explosive barrel, the momentum is retained and the Voodoo doll will slowly move to the other side. This is an elegant solution if you want to keep it vanilla to the max. There's just one disadvantage. The only way to give the Voodoo doll a push is through an explosive barrel, so the player will also receive damage and have its vision reddened by sheer pain. So yeah, cool stuff, huh? Voodoo dolls are an unintended feature in Doom, but over the years players found some very creative findings to make maps more dynamic and complex. Unfortunately, Voodoo dolls do not always work in cooperative mode, since each player will need its own Voodoo doll. It gets especially complicated when a source port allows more than 4 players. Man, I get a headache just thinking about it. Anyway, that's all there is to say about Voodoo dolls. A relatively obscure but powerful level editing object can really spice up your maps. Thank you very much for watching, and oh boy, this list is getting very long. But as always, a big shout out to my patrons: Andriy Diklin, Art Cox, Chris O'Neill, Cyprian Rusen, Curtis Carter, Joseph Coleman, QuakeGamer632, Rapu Hotelli, Roman Orehov, Sean Wang, Stephen Bone, Trevor Whalen, Turbine2K5. Your support lately has been amazing. Thank you very much. See you next time.